Welcome to this ritual session of Daily Lectio Divina for Tuesday, March 31st. I'm Kathleen Cahalan, a theologian at St. John's School of Theology and Seminary, where I teach a course on contemporary spiritual practice. And in these days, we are being asked to stay in place, to stay where we are. And Lectio is a practice, an ancient spiritual practice in the Christian tradition that invites us to stay with a sacred text, to read a text slowly, and to identify words or phrases through which God might be speaking to us. So we read a text three times. We place it first on our lips, and then in our minds, and in our hearts. I'm using the daily reading from the Catholic lectionary, which is my tradition, and I welcome all to practice with me today. Today's gospel is from John chapter 8, verse 21 to 30. You can have a Bible and read along with me, or just listen, and you might want to light a candle and have a journal. So I'll offer the reading three times and invite you to participate, to offer a word, a meditation, and a prayer, and I'll do so at each point too. Let's begin our practice by calling upon the Spirit to guide us. Sit quietly now, take some deep breaths, and listen to the Word of God. Listen for a word or phrase that speaks to you. Jesus said to the Pharisees, "I am going away, and you will look for me, but you will die in your sin. Where I am going, you cannot come." So the Jews said, "He's not going to kill himself, is he? Because he said, 'Where I am going, you cannot come.'" He said to them, "You belong to what is below. I belong to what is above. You belong to this world, but I do not belong to this world. That is why I told you that you will die in your sins. For if you do not believe that I am, you will die in your sins." So they said to him, "Who are you?" And Jesus said to them, "What I told you from the beginning, I have much to say about you in condemnation, but the one who sent me is true, and what I heard from him I tell the world." They did not realize that he was speaking to them of the Father. So Jesus said to them, "When you lift up the Son of Man, then you will realize that I am, and that I do nothing on my own, but I say only what the Father taught me. The one who sent me is with me. He has not left me alone, because I always do what is pleasing to him." Because he spoke this way, many came to believe in him. So take a moment to identify a word or a phrase that speaks to you. I heard the phrase, "The one who sent me is with me," and do what is pleasing to him. Now I'll read it a second time and invite you to meditate on the meaning of that word or phrase. Jesus said to the Pharisees, "I am going away, and you will look for me, but you will die in your sin. Where I am going, you cannot come." So the Jews said, "He is not going to kill himself, is he? Because he said, 'Where I am going, you cannot come.'" He said to them, "You belong to what is below. I belong to what is above. You belong to this world, but I do not belong to this world. That is why I told you that you will die in your sins. For if you do not believe that I am, you will die in your sins. So they said to him, Who are you? And Jesus said to them, What I told you from the beginning, I have much to say about you in condemnation, but the one who sent me is true, and what I heard from him, I tell the world. They did not realize that he was speaking to them of the Father. So Jesus said to them, When you lift up the Son of Man, then you realize that I am, and that I do nothing on my own, but I say only what the Father taught me. The one who sent me is with me. He has not left me alone, because I always do what is pleasing to him. Because he spoke this way, many came to believe in him. Now take a moment. What does that word or phrase mean for you today, and what might God be saying to you or asking of you or calling out to you today through that word? For me, the phrase, the one who sent me is with me. And in this final week of Lent, I'm finding these readings difficult. They have this opposition in them, and Jesus feels to me more and more mysterious. But what I hear in this text is to pay attention to him, because for me as a Christian, it's through him that we come into relationship with this great holy mystery, this I am, that Jesus identifies. And a phrase toward the end stood out for me, do what is pleasing to him. And I'd like that to guide me today, to do what is pleasing with Christ for the Father. Now I'll read the text a third time and invite you to offer a prayer from your heart. Jesus said to the Pharisees, I am going away, and you will look for me, but you will die in your sin. Where I am going, you cannot come. So the Jews said, He is not going to kill himself, is he? Because he said, Where I am going, you cannot come. He said to them, You belong to what is below. I belong to what is above. You belong to this world, but I do not belong to this world. That is why I told you that you will die in your sins. For if you do not believe that I am, you will die in your sins. So they said to him, Who are you? Jesus said to them, What I told you from the beginning, I have much to say about you in condemnation, but the one who sent me is true, and what I heard from him I tell the world. They did not realize that he was speaking to them of the Father. So Jesus said to them, When you lift up the Son of Man, then you will realize that I am, and that I do nothing on my own, but I say only what the Father taught me. The one who sent me is with me. He has not left me alone, because I always do what is pleasing to him. Because he spoke this way, many came to believe in him. I pray with Jesus to the Father that I will not die in my sinfulness, but that I will experience the one who sends me, who does not leave me alone, and that today my actions, my words, my thoughts, and my actions will be pleasing to you. Now I invite you to offer a prayer from your heart. And let's take a silent moment in contemplation. Slowly bring your awareness back. I invite you to take your word or phrase with you and repeat it to yourself. Join me tomorrow for Daily Lexio. I'm Kathleen Cahalan. May God's word sustain you today.